morning everybody. Now in this video we will study about the role of parliament. Basically the role of parliament can be divided into three parts. In this module we will concentrate on the first role of the government, and that is to select the national government. This is the first role of the parliament. Now to study how to select the national government, we have to recall the previous video. There we have studied about Lok Sabha. Now we have studied that for the elections of Lok Sabha, or it is also called as general elections, the country is divided into various constituencies. Now we have in the previous video we have studied the example that suppose Gujarat is divided into 26 constituencies and Bihar is divided into 40 constituencies. So, for the elections, from every constituency, many members will stand. So, the members who are standing for the election, maybe from Congress, from BJP, from Aam Aadmi Party, maybe from RJD, then maybe from BSP. There are so many parties in our country. So, people of different parties may stand for the election. But any one of them will only be elected from each constituency. Now, suppose after the Lok Sabha elections, when we counted the votes of the Gujarat state, we got that out of 26, suppose 10 votes were received by the BJP members. That means 10 candidates who won from different constituencies belong to BJP. And 8 constituencies got seat for Congress. That means 8 people who were chosen by the people belong to Congress. And some 4 are from other parties, and suppose some other 4 are independent candidates. And this will make 26 of Gujarat. Now suppose in Bihar when election results were counted, 20 seats went to Congress, 10 seats went for BJP and 5 for other parties, and suppose 5 for independent. So here we have taken only 2 states. Now let us count the number of seats for BJP, Congress, others and independent. So we can find that if we calculate only Gujarat and Bihar, we will see that 10 seats of BJP plus 10 seats of Bihar, there are 20 seats for BJP. Then 8 of Congress, 20 of Congress, so 28 of Congress. So similarly we will count the votes of all the parties. Here we have counted only 2 states, but it is possible that when all the states and union territories votes are counted, this may vary. At present we can see only 28 seats for Congress, 28 seats for Congress and only 20 for BJP. But when all the states are added, it may happen that BJP may lead. So this is what happened in the recent election, that BJP got the maximum number of seats. So the any party to form the government should get more than half the number of total Lok Sabha seats. Now total Lok Sabha seats is 543. Half of that is 271.5, so that is not possible. So 272. So whosoever party or whichever party gets 272 seats will form the government, or they will be called as the ruling party. So in our country BJP got more than 272 seats, so they formed the government. Now this is called as majority, that means they got the majority seats and they formed the government. Now what about the other people? Like if BJP has formed a government, that means 10 members of BJP from Gujarat and 10 members of BJP from Bihar, all are the ruling party. Now what about the rest of the people? They also won from their constituency, that means they are also important people. They are also the representatives of the people. So now rest of the members who could not form the government or whose party could not win, these people will sit in the opposition. So all these people will form the opposition party. So there may be more than one opposition party. So somebody will be made health minister, somebody will be HR minister, somebody will become finance minister, somebody will become home minister. So in that way, different ministries will be given to different members by the prime minister. It is the prime minister who appoints ministries to different ministers. Now, when prime minister makes some of the MPs as ministers, that means these ministers become the part of executive. That means some MLAs play dual role. One, they are MLAs of their own constituency also, and they are the ministers also. That means they are the member of parliament, in the part of legislature also, and in executive also they are the members, because they are the in charge of their own ministries. So in that way, there are many ministers also in our country. Now all 72 members cannot become the ministers. Some of them will become ministers, rest of them will be called as only MPs. Now it may happen that after the election, no party got 272 seats. 272 seats is required to form the government, because this is more than half of the total number of seats. But if it happens that no party got 272, suppose any party got only 250, so now they want few more seats so that it will become 272. So in that case, suppose BJP got 270 or 250, now 22 more seats are required. So what they will do? They will approach the other parties. So BJP will never approach Congress, because Congress is one of the major parties. So they will approach some smaller parties. Suppose they approach some other parties and all other parties agree to join with BJP. So in that case, the votes of the other parties, here if it is 9, it will become 29. But when we calculate for all over India, there will be more than 9. So these other members, all the independent members may also join with any of them. Either they may join with BJP or they may join with Congress. If they join with BJP and BJP is able to increase their number to 272, so then BJP will form the coalition government. Coalition means with the help of other parties. So if BJP is not able to gather or muster the support of other parties, then Congress will try for that. Or the second largest party will try for that. So the second largest party may happen that the second largest party is able to gather the support of other parties and they may also form the government. But more likely chances are there that the highest winning party or the party which got the highest vote, they only form the government by accommodating smaller parties. So if such government is formed, then we call it as coalition government. So now at present we are ruled by BJP, but BJP last time when win was it could not muster the support of only BJP members, so other members were also added, and last time we were having the coalition ministry which was called as NDA. So this is all about Lok Sabha. Now Rajya Sabha is one more body of the parliament. So we have seen that Rajya Sabha has 250 members. So actually the maximum number can be 250, but at present there are not 250 members in the Rajya Sabha also. Only 545 members are there in the Rajya Sabha. Out of that 245, only 245 members are there in Rajya Sabha out of 250. Out of 245, 233 are the elected members. That means in the previous module we have studied that the member of legislative assemblies of each state, they represent some people for the Rajya Sabha. So such people constitute 233, and rest 12 of the members are nominated by the president. So president can nominate any person who is expert in some field, like in sports, in cinema, in science or any other field. The president can nominate 12 such person to the Rajya Sabha, and they will become the Rajya Sabha MP. So now many of the actors like Rekha, then Hema Malini, then some sports, Sachin Tendulkar, all these people have become the member of Rajya Sabha. They were nominated by the president. So in this way, the main function of the government is to select the national government. To select the national government means this is all the selection process and executive. Here we, when we talk about national government, the main thing is executive, because legislature is already elected through the with the help of elections. But to select the executive is one of the function of the parliament. One of the role of the parliament is to select the executive, and that executive is selected by the prime minister. They are given various departments, various ministries.